Skipper, I've got a bit of golf trivia for you.
Have you?
Did you know that every ball ever released is longer, softer, straighter, goes higher, spins more, and is just around more outstanding?
Yeah, it's on every box.
Yeah. So we've got out and purchased 36 fan favourites, we'll just say.
Are they different?
Balls are all used on tour that, in our minds at least, compete directly with each other. We're going to have ourselves a good old-fashioned balls up.
Well, we all like the tech, especially you, but I reckon this test should be about benefit and what the ball is and what it does.
And as you're the only one who can actually hit it well repeatedly, we're going to actually leave this one completely to you. We're going to score these 3, 2, and 1. So best is 3 points, 2 points, 1 point, and the ball with the most points wins.
Kipper, right.
Over to you, my friend.
What have you done on them?
Without Kipper knowing a thing, literally, we've chosen the Titleist Pro V1X, Bridgestone Tour XS, and Callaway Chrome Soft X for this blind ball test. But will he be able to tell the difference between them?
Right, been given the cryptic balls, scribbled on by Philip, A, B, and C. And the first thing I know is he doesn't write letters very well, but do I notice a difference? Well, they all use the same shade of ivory. They're all white. If I'm giving votes, straight off the cuff on look, I'm going to go A, C, B in that order, 3, 2, 1 votes, because A's the simplest. Looking down at it, it's got the same sort of conforming dimple pattern, and I like that when I'm looking down at the ball, nothing too fancy. So that's my look taken care of. Now the test, I'm going to do chipping, putting, iron play and driving, and got to get the old balls cleared up here, and chipping first. So I'm going to do approaches first, and normally with an approach test, I like to do it inside of 50 metres because that's where you notice the most spin and feel amongst your ball and club head. So my first test here will be the spin I'm going to get. I kind of already know that I'm pitching into the wind, but it's going to be the feel of the ball on the face and ultimately whether I can judge whether I was long or short. Right, so I've picked the balls up and I've learned a few things from that little pitching exercise. One, I need to practice my wedges because the dispersion was terrible, but they did all react how I kind of thought they would, and that's one big tick for all three balls, okay? The one I liked the most, honestly, feel and receptiveness was A again, and the votes accordingly to C and B. But the other thing I learned is this is what it must feel like to be Phil. Small flat. So, putting time. The only thing I care about with putting, with a ball, is feel. It needs to feel consistent, but for me, personal, I guess, want, is I want to feel a little bit soft. Yeah, so A for me there, because I like the soft feel, and I already prefaced that, that's a, for me, clear standout. B and C, as it went on, I was just alternating, so I'm going to call them a draw, and give them both 2 votes. No one vote here, so both 2. So irons for me is all about height control, which then equals distance. So with these three sets of balls, I'm going to hit them standard, but then I will throw in a low ball, maybe even a high ball, just to see how the distance control alters, because that's really all I care about with mid iron shots. So look, if I'm going to have to rate them, definitely B. It was better for me to control my height. C and A, much of a muchness. I'll probably split them again, a couple of votes each. But B, geez, love the height on that. Driver test, and I'm excited because not many times do you get to hit 9 shots down a fairway like that. All I'm looking for here with driver is actually opposite to a putter. I don't really want it to feel too soft because it might not be spinning, but I feel it would be if I feel a soft sort of ball on the driver face. So I like it to feel hard and I like to jet off. First up, A. Actually didn't feel too bad, and by that I mean it didn't feel soft like I was expecting. All right, next up, B. Yeah, it is. That's 100% less spinny, definitely lower flighted than the A ball. I'm going to give a vote here, and it's tough because they all felt amazing. So I reckon the B ball gets my vote, 3. I reckon C actually gets the 2 votes and A 1, even though A felt really good. I was expecting it to be soft, but it didn't feel that way. But B, it was awesome. Yeah, I tell you, I enjoyed that.
What was the biggest discovery?
Honestly, tell the difference. In different zones. I guess that surprised me because they're all high-performing balls, but I thought they'd be much of a muchness. Yeah. No, they weren't. I could actually tell the difference.
All right, so A won.
Right.
So A was the winning ball. What did you like about A and what didn't?
Well, I love around the greens because I like a soft feel around the greens, and it's just I can feel like I can manipulate the ball more. But with irons, I felt it too spinny. Yeah. So,
so would it go in your bag? It won, but would it go in your bag?
No, probably B.
So B was... Okay, so A won the vote, B goes in the bag.
Which is which?
It's time to find out what's which.
Right. That's the B ball.
B.
Wow.
Pro V1 X.
Well, what's this one? That's C.
Chrome Soft X.
And that obviously is yeah.
A. Hey, who would have thought? XS. But the point about this, one of the reasons they say Tiger plays the XS is because it does spin more off the tee and on his own. He grew up controlling spin and manipulating spin.
Right.
So the other balls don't spin enough off the tee for him to actually have this advantage. Whereas the XS, oh, by spinning more, allows him to hit spinny ones or remove the spin from the shot, as opposed to you, who just pins the ears back and blows away.
He's a little bit better of a ball striker than me.
He's got you covered. So there you go.
Wow.
So that wins the vote. That's going in your bag.
Yeah.
Got to work out how to clean them up
you
now.
You've got to also work on your drawing skills, mate. B and C. I could hardly tell what numbers they were. And they weren't numbers, they were letters.